hours will be very beneficial. So what y'all think about that?
I think it was an excellent job.
Okay, they answered all the 5 questions over there. Well, they stated they claimed they said what? Explain, clear side, and they stated the topic.
Okay, good. So what you think, Ms.
I did an excellent job. That's my big
question. I think she could tell for some reason. Okay, so it was really good. The claim was straightforward. You explained, but in one part, hey, I forgot my something.
I can't hear you, Miss Corbin.
I said, can you put your mic on mute, both of y'all? All right, so the claim is clear, obviously. The so what, it could have been explained a little more right here. Hold on, wait. Oh, right here. So it is up to the individual. It can also help them pick out a career, okay? So you could have went a little bit further to say, so why is that part important, right? You could have said things like, you know, and then it takes down them not knowing what they want to do with their life, blah, 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 blah. Right? But that's the only little part that I see that could have been stronger, because you did explain yourself. You had a lot of examples, but your so what could have been just a little bit stronger, even though you do have one right here, right? Instead of what they can find out about themselves personally, instead of them always doing what their peers want to do. That's a really good so what, right? Because you kind of address peer pressure. But it would have been a little stronger, or it could have been a little stronger, if you would have actually said, you know, and this helps reduce the factor of them falling into peer pressure. But this was really good. Do you got any questions?
Yes, can I get 100 A on that paper, please?
No.
No, I'm good. Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, so sorry, this should say number 2, but this is a different one. Let me bring it up. All right. So the second one says, yes, high school seniors should perform community service before graduating, but when they go out into the real world, it can help them with different kinds of experiences, like bookkeeping, cleaning office, teach young people on their schoolwork, or help at a law office, because it can help them decide what they want to study in college. Thus, if they choose to go to college, it will help them achieve their expectation to survive in the real world.
I liked it how they stated their claim. Think they could have done more on the so what.
Yeah, they did a good job at explaining, though, when they said they can go to these law offices, they can go to be a bookkeeper, they can help young kids, blah, blah, blah. And all of this will help them see what they want to do in college. So they did a good job with going into more details. But I think they could have, like you said, Ms. I think they could have went a little further with some things, but it still was pretty good. All right, let's get into the grammar. All right, so singular and plural possessive nouns. First of all, what is singular and what is plural?
Single noun? It's been so long.
It's okay. I know. That's Yep, good job, right? And we know now it's a person, place, or thing, right? So if we put this together, because Ms. Nan told us that singular means when you're talking about one, and plural means when you're talking about two or more. That means, and then we know a noun is a person, place, or thing, right? So that means a noun or nouns possessing something. So either one noun or two nouns. So that may sound confusing. So what is the example of a plural noun? Think about that. Don't overthink.
He decided to go to the park.
Nope, that is still singular because you're talking about one noun.
Oh, so plural.
Yeah, plural. Yep,
and his mom went to the park, decided to go to the park.
Yep, or you can say, they, something like that. They.
Okay.
Yep, or you can say teachers, or you can say students, chairs, tables. Any noun that it ends in an S, but that's not always true because we have things like fish, right, and sheep. You don't say fishes, you don't say sheeps, you just say sheep, and you say fish, right? Because we still know you're talking about more than one. So we're going to talk about how to put that apostrophe in when we're talking about those nouns possessing something, okay? So let me pull up the worksheet, and it's also on my classroom. Yes, we're going to start with this one. By the way.
Good morning.
So we're going to
start. Get it, Mike.
We just getting into the grammar. We did the journals already, and we are talking about singular and possessive nouns. Okay, so I'm gonna read the top part, and then you don't have to write this down. The next page is what you should write down because it's more ordered, it's less words, and it's clear. It's more clear to see what you're writing. So it says, nouns used in the possessive form show ownership or possession. So ownership or possession. The apostrophe, and that is the symbol for apostrophe right here, is used to show the possessive form. Guides for forming possessives are given below. Okay? So it's telling you this is how to form possessive. So let's look at this first one. It says, to show the possessive form of most singular nouns, merely place the apostrophe after the last letter of the verb and add an S, right? So this is the most simplest one, right? If we're talking, and the only time you should be putting an apostrophe on any verb is if it is a noun, okay? So I'm going to say that again. The only time you should be putting an apostrophe S on any verb is if you're talking about a noun, okay? That's it. So let's look at this first example. The cat's kitten sleeps under the bed, right? Because this is singular. So we talk about one cat, but the cat is possessing something. So we got to put that apostrophe S. In this sentence, what is the cat possessing?
But Ms. Corey, you said that when you're talking about one person, you don't put the apostrophe.
I didn't tell you that.
Oh.
I said if we're talking about one person. I said if it's multiple people, you don't need to put a S on the end if you're talking about something plural that doesn't have a S, like fish.
Oh, okay.
So in this sentence, it says the cat's kittens sleep under the table. So sound in here is what?
Cats.
Okay. So the cat, right? How many cat is the cat there?
It's one cat, but they got kittens.
Okay. So what? Right. So we're talking about one cat. So what is that cat possessing in this sentence?
It's kittens.
Right. Okay. So that's it. So the cat's kittens. That's what we're talking about. Okay. So if you don't understand this part, speak up because the other part's gonna it just adds to it, so it's gonna get even more confusing. So if you don't understand now, just ask any questions you may have.
Okay, Miss Corey, shouldn't have an S on it too, or no?
No, it's only talking about one kitten. I mean, it could have an S, but this is only talking about one kitten, so it doesn't have an S.
Okay, good. said what you said then.
Okay. So now this is another one, right? To show the singular or possessive form, and then all of this is on a name sheet, all of this is on Google Classroom. You have to familiarize yourself with this stuff. Grammar is not something you're going to learn in a 30-minute session. It may take longer for you to grasp, and that is okay. So it says, to show the singular possessive form of a noun having one syllable. Put your phone on mute. Come on. It's okay. So it says, to show the singular possessive form of a noun having one syllable ending in an S or a Z sound, you place the apostrophe after the last letter and add the S. However, to show the singular form of a noun, and I know this may be confusing, but I'm going to break it all down. However, to show the singular form of a noun, of more than one syllable ended in the S or Z sound, only add the apostrophe. Okay. So, did I have somebody? Oh, okay. Let's look at this part again. So, if it has one syllable ended in the S or Z sound, you place the apostrophe after the last letter and add the S, right? But if it has more than one syllable ending in the S or Z sound, then you only add the apostrophe. So let's look at this one. This says, Mrs. Jones' car was expensive. Can y'all still see this? Mrs. Jones' car was expensive, but Mrs. Dickens' car ran better. I know. Everybody's wanting grammar, right? I told y'all. So, let's look at the analysis, what it says. It says, Jones's, singular noun of one syllable. An apostrophe and an S are added to show possession. Dickens, a singular noun of two syllables. An apostrophe alone is added to show possession. So, who knows what a syllable is? Because that's what's going to help you understand this whole rule. If you don't know what a syllabus is, then it's most certainly confusing to you. Who knows what a syllable is?
Yeah.
Okay. That's fine. So a syllable is, if you break the word up, how many parts of the word is it, right? And then I'm going to show you a lot of examples that you're going to get. So my name, okay, and this is how I learn syllables. So this is not me being childish. This is what I really do to learn, so I suggest you do it too. When we're talking about syllables, we're going to clap, and let me explain. So my name has two syllables, so Corey, right? So all y'all, Miss Don's name has one syllable, so it's Don. So Kendra's name has two. Kendra, right? Stuff can have three syllables, like, well, this is four. Dictionary, okay? I don't know really how to explain it without clapping, and I really wish I was in person to really break it down. But if you say, it's almost like if you say the word slow, or if you break the word apart, how many pieces of the verb is it, right? So if I say something like refrigerator, right? Because we say refrigerator. But all of those, if you break up that verb, it has multiple parts, or sometimes it can have one part, like Don. That's just one syllable, right? Or chair. You don't say chair. No. Right? So let me explain it with this, see if it'll help. So when it's saying Jones, right? So it's just Jones. So it's just one. So if you say Dickens, it's Dickens, right? It Does that make any sense at all whatsoever? I can find a video that'll probably do a better job, but that's how
I I understand it now.
Does everybody else get it, or y'all want me to go with some more?
I see. I'm reading it as you're going, and I'm kind of understanding it.
Wait, so any word, so let me see. So review, that's two. Like, you just got to really clap your hands. Like, I don't know, it may sound silly, but that's how I learned it when I was younger, and it stuck with me, and that's how I understand what a syllable is, right? So something like shoot, that's one syllable. You don't have to break that word down, right? Or something like, if you say television, right? That's the only way I can explain it. So all of this is saying is if something has one syllable, then you add the S. First of all, back up. This is only for, this rule is only for if something already ends in an S. Okay? So if something already ends in an S, what do you do? This is that rule. So if something already ends in an S, if it has one syllable, you're going to still do the apostrophe S just as you did over here. Right? You're going to still do the apostrophe S if it has one syllable. But if it has two syllables, and it ends with an S, you're not going to add the S, you're just going to add the apostrophe. I'm going to say it again. So if you, this is all talking about the same thing, all talking about a noun possessing something, a noun having something, right? So this noun that we're talking about is Mrs. Jones, right? Jones already ends in an S. So since we know that Jones ends in an S and it only has one syllable, it's okay to add that apostrophe S. But if we're talking about something that ends in an S, but it has more than one syllable, like Dickens, we know that the only thing we're going to do is add the apostrophe. We're not going to add another S because it's already too much. Think about it like this. If it has one syllable, it's enough room to add the apostrophe S. But if it has two syllables and already ends in an S, it's already enough, so you just add the apostrophe. Does that make any sense at all? I really wish y'all was in front of y'all.
I understand.
Thank you, in a sentence, how it's going in.
Okay, what'd you say, Don?
I understand.
Okay, good. Now we're talking about plural. So this is all singular, right? So this was one cat, one girl, right? And this is still one. Even though it ends in S, it's still singular because their name just ends in an S, right? That's the only reason why you see the S at the end, because their name ended. And this still is a singular noun. It's still one Mrs. Jones and one Mrs. Dickens. So plural possessive, to show the possessive form of a plural noun not ending in S, add the apostrophe in the S, right? So same thing you did right here, the girl's friend. So, but this is already plural, man is already plural, right? Because this is not, you don't add an S to the end. Those kind of words are like special plural words, like men, women, children. If I say that, you know that I'm talking about multiple, even though it doesn't have an S on the end, right? I'm not going to say the woman's unless I'm talking about possession, right? If I'm trying to say multiple women, I'm going to say women, right? If I'm trying to say multiple men, I'm not going to say mans. Them mans over there. No. Men. Right? But if something already doesn't end, if it's something that's plural and it doesn't have an S on the end, it's okay to just follow the same rule and just add the apostrophe S. Okay?
Okay, but already plural, so why did they add the S?
Because we're talking about possession. We're not talking about plural. Plural is not the main focus here. The main focus is possession, right? Having something. That's what we're talking about. Plural and possessive nouns, okay? So in this is saying...
The me is team, right?
Yeah, exactly. Because you know it's more than one man, but they have a team, right? So this is the plural part. This is the possessive part. And then this is what they possess, right? So the men, just because I see the E right here, that tells me that it's more than one. And then the apostrophe, which means that we are talking about something that these men have or they own. And that is this team. Give you another example. Are y'all with me or no? Ask any questions you may have.
I'm with you.
Okay.
I'm with you.
All right. So this one says the mice's hideout were all over the garage, right? So this is a plural form of mouse. You don't say mouses. Her house has mouses. No. Right? It's mice. Right? What's another example like that? Can't think of one off the top of my head. But anyway, so
what about woman and women?
Same thing. Woman and women, right? So if it's a woman's team, we're gonna add that same thing, apostrophe S, right? But if it's the woman's house, you're gonna put WOMAN apostrophe S because you still talk about one woman, but you're talking about what she possessed. Now if you're talking about what most women possess, you still ain't gonna mess with the N, you're just gonna change the E. You're just gonna change the A to an E. This will make most sense when we get to the next side of the paper. So if we're saying mice, right, that means we're talking about more than one. Just because I wrote the word like this shows you that I'm talking about more than one. But if I'm trying to say they possess something, I need to add that apostrophe S. So possess means to have, right? So if I'm saying they have something, I need to put that apostrophe S. And what do they have in this sentence? They have hideouts, right? Now let's look over here. This is going to make more sense, right? Oh, okay. Boom. So now this is talking about when something does not end, when you're talking about something plural. And you have to put the S to make it plural. We didn't have to put the S to make this plural, right? Because men already shows us that we're talking about more than one. Mice already shows us that we're talking about more than one. Children already shows us that we're talking about more than one, right? But this one...
That's what I'm saying, okay? Men is already plural, so why do you have to add the S?
You're not listening because we're talking about what the men have. That's what the apostrophe S does. Just because you see an S does not mean that it's multiple. This apostrophe S, go back up here. This apostrophe S, now used in the possessive form, show ownership or possession. The apostrophe is used to show the possessive form. To show the possessive form of a singular noun, merely place the apostrophe after the last letter and add the S. Same thing right here. Why are you confused? Why are you not confused right here then? Because this is the same thing.
Oh, okay. I was overthinking. Okay.
Yeah, with grammar, that's not going to help you at all because you're going to get very, 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 very confused. Very confused. Now let's look at this example, right? If you have to add the S to make it plural, that's a whole different story. We didn't have to add the S to make these plurals. We add the S to make it possessive to show that they have something, right? This one, all the girls' shoes were ruined by the rain. There's no way. This right here, why should be asked. But since we're talking about what more than one girl I have, we're gonna do girls and then the apostrophe. Okay? So we're talking about, let's look at this one. So horses, right? You have to make the horses plural. You have to add the S to show that we're talking about more than one horse. So since we are, and the rule is very simple, right? Since we already have an S, since it's already plural, all we're doing is adding the apostrophe to show what they own. And I'm going to say it again. Since it's already plural, right? It's already plural. All we're doing is adding the apostrophe because it already ends in an S. So we don't need to do another apostrophe S, right? Whereas this one is plural, but it does not end in an S, right? So since it doesn't end in an S, we can add the apostrophe S to show what it owns. But with this, we can't because it already ends in an S. So since it already ends in an S, all we do is add the apostrophe. Does that make any sense?
So you're basically saying it's like saying,
yeah, so the children, but if you're saying children's, anytime you're saying children's or man's, that means you're saying that they've got to own something or have something. So let me type something in the chat.
Because I was like saying the children's mother wanted to take them to the store, instead of saying the child's mother wanted to take them to the store.
No, both of those are correct. Because, but just in one, you're saying, you both talking about ownership, so let me type this right here. So, child, people, one child, only something. So, children, people, more than then if you have something like what we're talking about here, I'm going to make a whole other example, trees, right? So the trees branch equals tree. And then if we say trees branches, so that's more. Okay, so look at the chat. Can everybody see what I type?
No, I would have to get out of it.
This real quick. So look at the chat. As long as you can still hear me, right?
I don't know if you can still hear me or not, but
yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay.
Okay.
Let me use this
try.
One second. Let me explain it first. And then you can ask any question you want to ask. Okay? So if you look at all of these sentences, all of these sentences has an apostrophe, right?
Yeah.
So that means in each sentence, somebody is owning or having something, right? Because that apostrophe is the clue to say, oh, wait, we're about to talk about what somebody has or what somebody owns, okay? Anytime you see an apostrophe, that means somebody owns something or somebody has something, right? So, with this one, these are two separate examples. So, child, right? The child's whatever. That means this is one child owning something. Now, if I say children, I can put that apostrophe S because if I say children, you know that I'm talking about more than one child, right?
Yeah.
So, if I'm talking about more than one child, it's okay to add the apostrophe S just like we did up here because it doesn't already have an S at the end.
Okay.
If it doesn't already have an S at the end, add the apostrophe S, talking about more. So this doesn't have an S at the end. We can add an apostrophe S. Talking about one child owning something. So that child car, that child house, child whatever. Because you're talking about one child owning something. But this one, we're talking about multiple children owning something. And you know that just because it says children, right? But now, let's look at this. This is the important part. So let's look at the last one. So tree, branch, right? So this first one where I wrote the tree, branch, it tells you is how many trees?
One.
Because you don't see an S at the end of the tree. Just because you apostrophe S and a plural S is not the same thing.
Okay, I get it now. That's it. How you do that?
Okay, so the apostrophe S in the first one says that it's one tree and it has a branch. Okay? But the second one, since it says tree, that S for the apostrophe, right? That must mean we know that's gonna be a rule. I'm gonna write down. That must mean we know that it's more than one. So if with plural, I'm gonna write this in the chat. With plural, if S
ownership of what you're talking about also ends in the S to some point, right?
Say it one more time.
I said in plural sentences, like trees, trees, branches, when it's plural, its ownership also ends with the S sometimes too, right?
No.
Oh.
So you're talking about
like how you got it for tree branches.
What do you mean it's ownership in as ownership? Because the apostrophe is the ownership. So you can't have an S apostrophe and another S unless you're talking about a name, like I said, Jones. But if you're talking about something that's not a name, not a proper noun, if you're not talking about a name, you cannot have an S apostrophe and another S.
So when does that rule with the ownership and the persuasive, that don't apply to this session right here?
This is all ownership. Anytime you see a apostrophe, that's showing the ownership.
Ownership.
So re-ask your question.
So like how you wrote more than one tree. You see how you say tree branches? I was looking at the branches.
Yeah, I have to say.
You have to say S too, right? Because you're talking
tree, about the branches. Well, okay, exactly. I didn't understand what you're
okay.
saying.
Yeah, I know how to see it.
For
okay.
sure. Yeah, you have to. Right? Okay, so let me write this rule in the chat, and then we're going to go back. So if S is before the apostrophe, then the noun is plural. So if S is after the apostrophe. Unless we're talking about got any questions? So this is the rule that I wrote, and I think this will be helpful if y'all write this down if you haven't problem. So it says plural. If the S is before the apostrophe, then the noun is plural, right? So it's hypotrophy, so we know we're talking about more than one tree, which is a tree, right? So the S, because the S is before. Now, if the S is after the apostrophe, like when it says trees, trees branch, talking about one tree, so it's singular. Does this rule make sense? If y'all read this, does this make sense to y'all?
Yeah, to me it does.
Okay, what about everybody else?
I was busy writing it down, but I understand it.
Okay, what about you, Liz?
I'm still having a problem with children.
Why? What's the problem?
Okay, when do you put the apostrophe after that? Okay, I was thinking of this. Okay, children have a playroom. So I say that.
No, that whole sentence is incorrect, though.
Right.
Exactly.
Because you can't say children have something. Say the children's playroom, and then if you're talking about one child and they have a playroom.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
This is incorrect. That's what I'm saying. Don't overthink. Like, because if you're trying to think your own rules and examples, you are going to confuse yourself, and you will never understand grammar. You cannot sit there and think in your head examples and all of this stuff, because you will confuse yourself, and I don't know how to know other way to put it. Yeah, but that's the way grammar, you're going to really defeat yourself, I'm telling you. With other stuff, it's like, okay, if you overthink, you can't lead up to the right answer, but this grammar, no, it's like a web, and you're going to spin yourself in a web, and you're going to look up, and you ain't going to have no idea what you're talking about, and you're going to get everything confused from the beginning. I'm telling you, that's not what you want at all. All right. So
okay, I'm good. Yeah, I'm good.
Let's go back to this, and then we're gonna do a couple examples. Yeah. Hold on, I'm about to put it back up. Oh, it's already up on y'all's screen. It ain't up on mine. Here we go. Alright, so same thing like example two, right? It says the horse's barns. So, since the apostrophe is before, I mean, since the apostrophe is after the S, excuse me, hold on.
I'll be getting sick out of this
morning. I know, right?
Now you're just talking too much.
I look, for real, that's what it is.
You need a break, drink some water.
You don't have the corona deal.
Don't even wish that on me. So, example two says, the horse's barns were painted white, okay? So, since we see that the apostrophe is after the S, that's showing us that we talk about more than one, right? Yeah. We talk about more than one horse because the apostrophe is after the S, okay? Same thing with the teachers. We're talking about more than one teacher because the apostrophe is after the S. Now, this apostrophe was in between the S or in front of the S, that means we only talking about one teacher. So the teacher's part, the teacher's lesson, right?
I got it.
All right. So let's do some examples. Do y'all got any other questions before we go to the example? I still want to show y'all this.
On a different slide now.
Exactly, unless it's literally just only her.
Exactly, okay.
Yeah, but it'll be, you can put the teacher apostrophe as classroom, because teachers usually
because it's her classroom.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, so this is what I want y'all to write down. These are the rules. So, not now, though. We don't got time, because I want to still get to some examples into one of the reading passages, okay? So, these are the rules that you can write down for your, just like a rule. Like, this is all the rules that I just said put into one chart. That's why, if you want to write some down and take some notes, write this whole blue part where it says rules that work. Okay? These are all the words. I mean, all the rules. So I just want to show y'all that, and that's the scan 8. So you can write that down in your notes. Well, let's go back to...
Okay, you're gonna post these, right?
It's already up there.
Okay, I just want to make sure it's going to be on the Google Classroom for, like, the examples and stuff.
It's already on Google Classroom. Alright, let's look at some
that's on scan 8?
Yes.
Okay.
So let's look at this. So now this worksheet is really cool, and this is up there too. We not gonna be able to do the whole thing. But this is sorry y'all. We not gonna be able to do the whole thing, but this is a very good thing. So, what we are doing is, let's just read the directions. Use the apostrophe to form the singular and plural possessive for each singular expression. Make both nouns plural in the plural possessive, blah, blah. Okay, that's why I didn't want to read that, because that's kind of confusing, so we're going to ignore that. I'm going to tell y'all what to do. So, basically, it's giving you examples of a statement. And each of the statements, somebody, a noun, possesses something. So it wants you to make it a singular version and a plural version. So for example, A saying the bill of the doctor. So that means who is the noun and what are they possessing? Tell me.
Doctors is the noun and he's possessing the bill.
Exactly. So in the singular form, it wants you to talk about one doctor. You can talk about two doctors. So if it was one doctor, who we talking about, it'll be doctor apostrophe S Bill. But if we're talking about more than one doctor, that apostrophe is gonna come after that plural S. Does that make sense? So this one, number 2, says the video of the movie. So if we're talking about one movie, it's gonna be movies. Oh, and then let me go back to this, because this is what Kendra pointed out. So like you said, right, if we talk about more than one, that other word needs to end in an S, right? Because if we're talking about more than one person...
But you see how...
Go ahead.
You see how the D said it's dog teeth? They changed the tooth to a teeth because it's more than one.
Exactly. And they not going to say no tooths. That's
wrong.
The S. Exactly. Right? So, if you talk about more than one, then you are going to end, you are going to put that next word, should be plural. Right? And this next word, the dog's teeth, that's plural too. Just because it don't end in an S don't mean it's not plural. Just like you've seen for men. Right? So, see, the pencil of the secretary. So, if we talk about one secretary, it's just the secretary apostrophe S pencil. But if we're talking about more than one, it will be the secretary's apostrophe pencil. Same thing, the tooth of the dog. So if we talk about one dog, we're just going to say the dog's tooth. But if we're talking about more than one, we're going to say the dog's teeth, because we need to make both of those plural. Does that make sense? We're going to do the example. Okay, who want to try to do number 1? I know it's kind of a difficult one. How about we type when we do that? So, who want to do number 1?
I'll try number 1.
Kendra, you can do number one. Dwayne, do number two. And then Don, do number three. And I want y'all to, type it in this chat. Y'all know how to use the chat that's already on the video, so you don't have to exit out.
No, what happens is whoever Mike is unmute and talking, that's who image it shows. That's how Google Hangout works. So you might see me, but I think they're going to miss Corey.
What the text, the example was, And what I'm trying, what we're trying to get you to do is make it plural, right? So it'll be the hero's wish. So wishes of the heroes, not quite. So with that being said, do you understand it better? Can you go back and redo it, or do you still not understand what I'm saying?
So basically it'll be hero's wish, and then the plural will be the hero's wishes.
Yes, but can you type it so I can see where you put the apostrophe and stuff, please?
Okay.
Okay, good job, Kendra. I see that your second one. Good job.
Oh, I thought that was wrong. Because I changed, so we know we're talking about more than one woman because I changed it to women.
Exactly. So that's the only time where you can still do that apostrophe S when we talk about plural, because it doesn't end in that S already.
Gotcha. Okay.
Ms. Don, can you try another one? So, Dwayne, not quite. So, for the second one, your comma needs to be after the S if we're talking about hero's wishes, right? If we're talking about more than one hero, it should be written like this.
HEROS apostrophe then.
Yes.
Okay.
Do you get why? Do you understand that?
Yeah, because you want to try to talk about more than one.
Yeah, exactly. So if we're talking about more than one, you gotta put that apostrophe after the S.
Okay.
So can you try another one for me? Try number 6. Is done, not quite. For the men, it's already plural, so you do not need, and it doesn't end in an S, so you do not need to put the apostrophe after the S, okay? So one of those things is, if it's already plural, Ms. Don, and it doesn't end in an S, you just still write it the same way. So if it's this, you put it like this. If it's this, you put it like this. Same thing you did for the children. So what's the difference? Oh, see, that's my fault, because I didn't even catch that the first time. Yeah, it should be written like that. So if it's plural and it doesn't end in an S, go ahead and do the apostrophe S. But if it's plural and it doesn't end in an S, you have to do add the S and then the apostrophe. So, Dwayne, for the one that you just wrote, how many puppies do the dog have? you just wrote.
One.
So why do you have more than one puppy then?
That's what I thought by being in plural. And I was about to write the regular one.
Oh, so this is supposed to be the plural one?
Yeah.
Okay, so you just need to move that apostrophe once again. If you're talking about more than one of something and it doesn't end in an S already, if you had to add the S, you need to put the apostrophe after the S. Okay, so if we're talking about more than one of something and it doesn't end in an S, you add the S and the apostrophe.
So be dogs with the apostrophe after the S.
Yes.
And then the singular would be D-O-G apostrophe S puppy.
Exactly.
Okay. That's why I was writing in the second part. That's why I was trying to fix it.
No problem. So since we only got about 10 minutes left, like 15 minutes, let's just keep doing this then. And then I can upload another worksheet because we don't have time to go over the reading. If you want to go over the reading, you can come back at 1. You can do the readings at 1. Or you can schedule a one-on-one tutoring with me tomorrow. Or if you don't want to go over the readings and you just want the answers, I can post the answers. It's all up to you. Okay? So I'll post the answers to everything tomorrow, to the reading rather, tomorrow. The author's life. The author's life. What? Which one are you doing? Number 9, okay. Okay, good job, Dwayne. So... This is Miss Dawn. What's the difference between what you wrote? I don't understand it.
I'm doing number.
What are you writing for number 2, Miss Dawn? I understand you're doing number 9. What are you saying? One is plural, one is
singular.
I don't get it.
What number you
want
to do?
10. Author is singular.
Okay, so where's the plural?
The plural is behind because you said. When it doesn't end, when there's no S, I don't need to put the S
in. No, it's not. You listening to the part that you want to listen to. You open out the part that you don't want to do. You put your own stuff in the middle. You can't do that. That's what I'm telling you. If it does not end in an S, and we are trying to talk about more than one thing, you need to add the S. The only time you do not add the S to make it plural is only if it's one of the words like children, women, mice, if it's already turned into plural without adding the S. If you cannot do that, if it's not another word that makes it plural, you need to make it plural. If we're trying to talk about more than one
Okay, that was my fault. I didn't understand, okay.
No, Miss Don, don't keep, because you keep going back and saying, oh, I get it, and then you're doing it wrong. What don't you understand? What's confusing? Let's talk about it. Like, just ask the questions. Don't keep trying to say you get it, and then you're doing it wrong, and then you don't get it. What's confusing?
I don't know when to add the S in the apostrophe. That's what's getting me.
So, did you read what I wrote? rules? Did you read the rules? Did you look at the paper? Were you listening? Because I wrote down when you add the S, when you add the apostrophe, I put it in the chat. It's all there. I don't know. Like, I can't break it down any further. Like, I can't make it any more simpler. Like, I'm trying my best to make it as plain as possible. If you are trying to make something possessive, right? Something possessive meaning somebody has something. If you are trying to make something possessive, and you're talking about one thing, all you do is add that apostrophe S. But if you're trying to make something possessive, and you're talking about more than one thing, you need to make it plural, just like you do with any other thing, right? Any other time you make something plural, you add an S, you need to do that. But you're going to just put the apostrophe after it. Now, the only time you don't put the apostrophe after what you've made plural.
Can I try one more?
Mm-hmm. You can do number 11. Dwayne, can you do number 12? Good job, Kendra.
Yeah, I was in the process of doing number 10. Well, I'll do 11.
Thank you.
You want me to do another one?
Yep, do number, hold on, I'm going to tell you what you want to do. Number 19. Now,
that one was a little confusing. You see it?
Yes, but you did it right. Great job. And that's why I wanted you to do that one. Great job.
Okay.
Yes, good job, Ms. Dodge. Yes, perfect.
Yay!
The second one is the plural, right?
Yeah.
So, when you're talking about more than one wolf, you write it like this. Wolves, right?
Okay, I see.
Yeah, so that one was a little hard because,
I didn't think of it that way. I was like, okay, wolves. And I'm like, but now that you show me, I'm like, okay, wolves.
And then you got to make that second verb plural, so we cry, right? Ms. Dawn, can you do number 20?
Which one you want me to do?
Hold on. So, Ms. Dawn, you do number 20. Dwayne, you do number 17, and then Kendra, you do number 23. Okay. So for you and Kendra, the partnership is singular, so you don't have to put, it's not the knife with an S at the end, so it should look like this for the singular.
I knew that.
Okay. And then for the other one, it should look like this. Okay. Because that is, you know, change it, right? You got to change the whole word, but when you change it, it's still ending in that S, right? So it's different from man and men, right? So if I'm saying men, I'm not changing the N, I'm only changing the will. But see, this one, you're changing the N, so then you gotta, you still put that apostrophe at the end, if that makes sense.
Okay, go back to what you wrote.
Okay, yes, Miss Don, you getting it. Yes, great job. Okay, we gonna all do one more. Okay, the one I see you wrote yours too. Okay, good. So the first one is the plural, and then the second one, not quite. So the second one is very, very close, you Jazz. So if we only, if we talking about singular, right? So it should look like this, right? Because we're only talking about one. Yes, great job, Dwayne. No, wait. No, not a part. Yeah, so that's if we're saying the spy's glasses or something like that. We're talking about the city possessing something. So if the city's possessing something, the cities need to be changed to the possessive. And the second thing that you just wrote, the spies, that would mean that the spies are possessing something. So what you wrote is not wrong. You just got it confused with who's possessed, who's doing the possessing. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I see it.
Okay. So, okay, Dwayne, I'm gonna come for you again. So Dwayne, can you do number 22, and then that'll be your last one. Take your time.
Corey left?
I don't know. Yeah, it looks like she ended up being knocked out.
Yeah, so I'm going to assume she possibly had connection issues. So,
crazy. Are you going to give us something to do?
Well, class is over at what, 10:30, right?
Yeah,
10:30.
So, Miss Dunn, if you can tell me the difference between a plural and a possession.
See, Miss Dawn?
Miss Tracy, see, I love you so much until you said that.
Well, you
asked for it.
I'm so sorry. I am so sorry.
Go ahead, Miss Dawn. Tell me the difference between a plural that ends in an S and a... Hey, Miss Corey, I had Miss Dunn ask me, was I going to give them some work since you got disconnected? I asked Miss Dunn to tell me the difference between a plural and a possession. So she's getting ready. She's getting ready to do that now.
Don't listen to her, Miss Corey. Okay. A plural is when you're talking about more than one.
Yeah.
And singular is when you're only talking about one.
Tell me about the possession, though.
You know, so Miss Tracy, I really did love you.
She tried. It's not crazy.
I truly did love you. Really.
Okay, Miss Corey, I'm giving it back to you.
What about the possession? Plural is when you're talking about more than one that possesses something. Singular is talking about one thing that possesses something. Was that right, Miss Corey?
Yeah. So. The one
is Tracy, leave me alone.
Okay, Dwayne, so good. You just forgot to make that second verb plural again. But that's okay, because that's not something that we can't work on, okay? That's something very small. It shows that you get the apostrophe and you get the possession part. You just forget to make the second verb plural, which is no big deal. That's something we can work on. If you understand the possessive, then you good. I don't see nobody else thing. Maybe it's because I exited off. I sure was like, they got real quiet over there, but I didn't realize that I closed out the app.
That's supposed to be piano on the second part of it.
Yep.
P-I-A-N-O apostrophe S on pianos?
No. So you, the piano isn't possessing anything. So with the pianos, all you're doing is making it plural. Just adding the S on the S on the end.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Miss Corey, so you add the S after museum?
No. Yeah. He got everything right. Besides, he only thing is he forgot to make the second word plural, right? So you know how if you make the first word is plural, the second word got to be plural too. So that's all.
Right.
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah. So let me put this up, and then this is the last thing. I can do my 15-page paper unless somebody want to do it for me. I guess nobody wants to do it for me, then.
You gotta do
it. Miss Corey, we love you, but look, not that much.
Did you say a 15-page essay?
Yeah. I ain't hear it. What happened?
No, I said I'm gonna put this last thing up, and I'm gonna let y'all go so I can do my paper unless somebody wants to do it for me. Everybody got real quiet, then.
I'll try to help.
When you said it was 15 pages.
You said I lost you there, huh? And I ain't even started, huh?